In this video, I'm going to explain to you Docker's architecture and its key components. Everything you do in Docker is based on the foundations that I discuss here. So listen carefully. As a bonus, at the end, I will also share the only 3 commands you need to know to do 80% of your tasks in Docker. Let's get started. Welcome to the 3rd lesson of Docker from Zero to Infinity series. My name is Raghav. And the first thing you need to know here is that Docker has a client-server architecture.
Wow!
We use a client to tell Docker what to do. The Docker CLI is the official command line tool from Docker. Master the CLI and you'll never need another client. The Docker daemon is the server that manages all Docker objects and performs operations on them. It is a background process that must run on every host where you intend to run Docker. The daemon exposes a REST API, so you don't have to necessarily use the Docker CLI. You could just make direct HTTP requests or even write your own client. But the CLI does make things a lot easier. Together, the client, the server, and its API make up the Docker engine. Now let's see the basic Docker workflow to understand some more key components and how they interact with each other. Imagine you've just developed a shiny new Hello World microservice and you'd like to run it as a container. The first step is to create a Docker file. That's a fancy name for a configuration file in which you specify how to compile and run your application and the dependencies that need to be included. Next, use the client, or more specifically the Docker CLI, to tell the daemon that you would like to use your Docker file to create an image. An image is a blueprint containing instructions for creating a container. Think of it as a zip file stored on disk that contains your application and all its dependencies. The daemon, of course, creates this image and stores it on your host machine. Now, invoke the CLI to run a container using your newly created image. You can create as many containers from an image as you like. Once you're happy with how your app runs inside the container, you probably want to share it with others. So you push your image to the registry. A registry is a server-side application for storing and distributing your container images. It lets you push new Docker images you create and pull existing ones onto your system. Registries also allow authentication so you can share your images privately. Some popular examples are Docker Hub and AWS Elastic Container Registry. Even Artifactory can be used as a Docker registry. These are the key components of Docker architecture and their interactions with each other that make the magic happen. In lesson 5, I will explain Docker's workflow in much more detail with coding exercises. I promise. There are 2 more important objects in Docker that you need to know about: storage volumes and networks. Suppose your application produces some logs that you'd like to preserve, or maybe you're running a database inside a container. Either way, you don't want to lose your data when the container dies or gets replaced. So if you only store your data inside a container, it is almost guaranteed to be lost. A storage volume allows you to possess data generated inside your container even after the container dies. You can attach a volume to a container and start possessing your data. Then there's networks. A network allows Docker containers to connect and communicate with each other and with the workloads running outside of Docker, such as a process running directly on the host machine. Docker has different network drivers for different use cases. I'll explain networking in a lot more detail in a future video. But for now, just know that the default driver is Bridge, which allows containers running on the same host to communicate with each other. So this is what it all looks like now. Do you know that just 3 commands in the CLI allow you to do 80% of your tasks in Docker? Let's check them out. Pull lets you download an image from registry. This is how you download images to run locally, whether it is your laptop or servers in your infrastructure. Build allows you to actually build a Docker image using your Docker file. It has plenty of options to customize the final image created. You'd probably be using the tag option to specify a name and a tag for your image. Run is used to run a container by specifying a Docker image. You can configure a lot of options, such as the port to open on the host, run the container in the background, and so on. Here is a question for you. If your container's application is producing some files that you'd like to store in AWS S3, how would you achieve this? Tell me a solution in the comments and let's get this discussion started. In the next lesson, I'll show you how to install Docker. Whether you're setting up a local development environment or preparing a production server for deploying containers. Keep leveling up your DevOps skills with me. Subscribe to my channel now. Press the like button and show me your support. See you in the next video.